Welcome to today's devotional. I am so glad to have you join me as we continue our journey through the book of Romans. Today we tackle chapter 6 and I will share two reflections from the book of Romans chapter 6. Reflection number one is that anyone that has believed in Christ Jesus, they are a new creation. You have newness of life. And we know that scripture interprets scripture. So between verses 1 to about verse 10, Paul talks about the newness of life that we have in Christ Jesus. And this is how he describes it. He says that if we have been joined with Christ through baptism, anyone that has been joined to Christ through baptism, you died with Christ, you were crucified with Christ, and you were raised from the dead with Christ, so that the old man of sin was crucified, was buried, and a new man came up out of that death. That is why 2 Corinthians 5:17, Paul argues and says that if any man is in Christ, he is a new creation, the old is gone and the new has come. So if you have believed in Jesus Christ, you are a new creation. You are buried with him. And when Jesus Christ was buried, Paul tells us in Romans chapter 6 that he broke the power of sin. And so because we were buried with him and we were raised from the dead, the Bible says that sin no longer has power over us. I know that is difficult to believe, but that is the truth, that we are no longer slaves of sin. Sin no longer has mastery over us because we were crucified with Christ, we were buried with him, and we were raised from the dead together with him. And so because he broke the power of sin, it means that therefore we also are no longer slaves to sin. And Paul continues to say this, that if Christ broke the power of sin, then we should reckon, he uses that word reckon. In other words, we should consider ourselves dead to sin, but alive to God through Christ Jesus. I once listened to a friend of mine explain the difference between justification and sanctification. All along between verses, I mean chapter 1 to chapter 5, we have been arguing for justification, and we said that justification is to be made right with God without us doing anything, just by believing. And we are accepted by God simply because of the work of Christ on the cross. And sanctification now, the second bit that we want to introduce in this next chapters of Romans, sanctification simply means set apart from sin unto God for righteousness. A friend of mine who had made reference to a few minutes ago, when he was describing these two words, justification and sanctification, he used this illustration. He said that when you go to a hospital and they run all these tests on you, any kind of test that you can think of, they run all of them on you, and all those results come back negative, and the doctor gives you a clean bill of health, you don't go out of that hospital and start living recklessly. You will be so careful so that you can maintain that status of good health that you have received from the hospital. And so my friend arguing the difference between justification and sanctification, he says that in justification, because our work is only to believe, the first bit of our salvation, when we confess, when we receive Jesus Christ, we are declared righteous. We are declared right with God without works, without observance of the law. But in the second bit now of salvation, which now Paul introduces to us in chapter 6 and verses 12, Paul says, then after now realizing that you are a new creation, there is a newness of life that you are supposed to start living. And so he says, you should now start being careful how you live your life, so that you don't yield yourself to sin, because you are not anymore under sin. You are not a slave to sin. And Paul says, now yield yourself as a slave to righteousness. And Paul argues and says that which we yield ourselves to obey, we are slaves of that thing. When we yield ourselves to obey sin, we are slaves of sin. But when we yield ourselves to obey God, then we are slaves of obedience or of righteousness. And so now Paul here introduces to us the second aspect of our salvation, that we need to work it out every day, so that sin does not have dominion over us, so that because the power of sin was broken, we don't give it now opportunity to do anything in our lives. And so those are the two reflections that I wanted us to share today. Number one, that you died, that you were crucified with Christ. Now consider yourself dead to sin, but alive to God through Christ Jesus. Number two, do not yield yourself to sin. Do not yield your members, members of your body. Paul uses the word instruments. Do not yield them. Do not surrender them as instruments of unrighteousness. Like that illustration that I used, that once you have been declared righteous, justified by God, the second bit now, it is for you to work in collaboration with the Spirit of God as He enables you every day, because grace, the Bible says that grace has appeared to all men, teaching us to say no to unrighteousness so that we may live godly lives. Now, the second bit of our salvation is to continue yielding ourselves to God and to obedience, to continue yielding members of our body as instruments of righteousness. Please let me know, what are your thoughts on Romans chapter 6? We have been moving, bit by bit, chapter by chapter every week. Read on ahead as we share next week from Romans chapter 7. As usual, thank you so much for taking your time to click on this video. This is the Bread of Life Devotionals. If you're new here, please subscribe, share with your friends. Let's spread the gospel, the good news of our Lord Jesus Christ to our friends and our circles. God bless you.